G'day, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. Welcome to this video in which I'm going to talk about the topic of counting on 1, 2, or 3 for addition. So these are some of the easier addition number facts, adding only 1, 2, or 3. The worksheets that go with the video come from this book, which is from our Let's Go series, book number 4, Addition and Subtraction Revision. These are all addition worksheets. In the book, the following set is subtraction, counting back 1, 2, or 3. All right, so I've talked about this topic before. If you've seen lots of my videos, you'll have encountered this strategy previously, but if not, then hopefully this will be very helpful and useful to you. So we've got two resources that we're going to use for this strategy, as we do pretty well for all addition and subtraction number facts, and that's 10 frames and number lines. So let's look at the 10 frames for a start. A 10 frame is a really good device for helping students to recognize the numbers up to 10 in what we call subitizable patterns, which means they can recognize the number without actually counting the counters. So you'll be able to look at that and see straight away there are 5 counters. We want children to recognize that in the same way. And by saying they're not counting, what I mean by that is they're not saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they're not using the sequence of number names. They're simply glancing at it and seeing. Okay, this isn't really about 10 frames, but that's a quick introduction to that. And the other part of using 10 frames is we have a couple of choices. So we can either start them as they were just now in pairs and have odd and even numbers as we go up to 10, or we can fill up one row one at a time up to 5 and then the second row. So let's continue with it like that. Since the number's 5, it's going to be quite convenient. And we're counting on 1, 2, or 3. So the question for the student will be, what is 5 plus 1? What is 5 plus 2 or 5 plus 3? Or the turnarounds for those. So we could say, what is 3 plus 5, 2 plus 5, or 1 plus 5? Realizing, of course, that we want the students to count on the small increment. And the increments only go up to 3, so we're never going to count on 4 or above. We're only counting on 1, 2, or 3. And if we have another number with 1, 2, or 3, we always start with that number, start with a large one and count on the small amount. All right, so the question might be, what's 5 and 1 more? We want the students to recognize that the answer is going to be 6, but we don't want to use the 10 frame as a sort of physical calculator where you put the counters on and then say, how many do you have now? Let's count them, or something like that, or even let's subitize them. We're not using the 10 frame to find out what the answer is. We're using the 10 frame to help the students imagine it and visualize it and picture it in their minds, that sort of thing. So rather than put the counter on straight away, we might say, what number is this on the 10 frame? How many will there be if we add one more? Can you picture it in your mind? What will it look like? That sort of thing. So we want the students to visualize that. And we could use the same color or a different color. I don't particularly mind, but this emphasizes the 5 plus 1. Similarly, 5 plus 2, 5 plus 3. So we're asking the students, as I said, to picture it in their mind and think what the answer will be before we actually show it with the counter. So we'll probably show the 5 to start with, but the sum, the 5 plus something else, we want them to picture it first. Obviously, some students won't be ready for that when they're very young, so they may need the counters to support that level of thinking, but that's where we're going with this. And of course, ultimately, we want to stop using the 10 frame altogether and say, what's 5 plus 2? And we want the students to think of those numbers. And the 10 frame gives them a visual model on which to base that sort of thinking. All right, using the number line is not really this. I was going to say it's much the same thing. It's the same sort of principle that we want the students to visualize and think in their heads. And again, not use this as a calculating device. But it does represent the numbers differently. For a start, there are no counters there. So there are no objects that are being counted or the numbers not being represented by physical objects, but rather by the symbols or the written numerals from 0 to 10. And of course, they're written in sequence from 0 to 10. So what we're looking at is the sequence of counting numbers. So whereas if we were doing another number fact like 4 plus 5. We could do that on a number line, but it's slow and cumbersome, and it's, you know, when the numbers get larger, the number line's not all that useful. We can use it, but 10 frames are going to be more useful for a lot of those examples. But for counting on 1, 2, or 3, the number line actually emphasizes what we want, which is the counting on aspect. So if we were to say, what is 6 plus 2? Or, and we would use other language, I meant to say that before. So we could say 6 and 2, or 6 and 2 more, or 2 more than 6. You know, any language that's similar to that, encapsulates the addition operation, will be fine. So 6 plus 2, use the number line to visualize the answer. Again, we're not necessarily, or especially when the students are able to do it without actually recording it on the number line, we're not going to say, all right, find the 6, count on 2 more, what number do you get to? That's okay when the students are just learning it, but what ultimately we want them to do is to be able to look at the number line and see what the answer is, or work it out in their head, and then of course do it without the number line. But obviously, at the learning phase, the students can see that there are two jumps. If we're starting from the 6, we're moving on to, then we get to 8, and so on. We can talk about the fact that if you start with an even number, you'll get to an even number. If we add 2, if you start with an odd number, you get to an odd number. There are all sorts of patterns and so on that can be seen here. You've got the whole set to work with, starting with any number from 0 all the way up to 10 to add on 1, 2, or 3. Some are going to be really easy, some are going to be harder than others. There'll be a whole lot of things that you can talk to students about. So I just want to say this, although when you look at the worksheet, it's just a plain set of practice exercises, our intention here is not just to give the students busy work. We're not just saying, here, do a page of these and be quiet. We're using this as a vehicle to help them practice thinking. So the most important thing, because I think when we look at these, it would be easy to look at that and go, well, these are too easy. You know, I can't see any great intellectual challenge here. The challenge is getting it in your head. So for the children, we want them to be able to visualize, think about the numbers in their head. In the case of the number line, think of the sequence of numbers in their head. So another way to do this, just on that particular point, using the sequence, is not to use any resources at all and say something like, think about the number 8. In your head, I want you to count on 2 more and tell me what you get to. So I ask them to count silently without even whispering, 10, you know, so they can think in their head, 9, 10. So that's the aim of all number fact strategies, is to help students to think about it in their head and reach the answer accordingly. Okay, I'm perhaps talking a little bit long on this one. Thanks for being with me this week. I look forward to talking to you next time.